Bring back rock. Hey, this is Dean with Bring Back Rock. And today I'm going to talk to you again about a band that had just one major label release back in the day. Now, they have done more since then. They did have some success with that release. So maybe it's a band you missed back then. Maybe it's, I'm going to kind of jog your memory and you're going to say, oh, I remember who they were. Maybe you hated them. Maybe you still listen to them to this very day. Either way, I'm going to tell you a little bit about Roxx Gang. And then, like always, we'll play a little music and I'll see you again at the end. Roxx Gang, a glam band out of St. Petersburg, Florida. Now, lead singer Kevin Steele had his mom murdered when he was just 9 years old. This was obviously a dark time in his life, and he became an avid reader, retreating into books. This is until somebody gave him albums by bands like David Bowie, Lou Reed, and Mott the Hoople. The sound and the look made him think these guys were like from another planet. And that's when his journey down the rock and roll road began. Kevin formed Roxx Gang with guitarist Eric Carroll, who unfortunately met an untimely death not long after. He was involved with some shady characters. They had a meeting set up on a bridge. I don't know why you have a meeting on a bridge, but that's where it was, where he fell to his death. Whether foul play was involved or this is an accident is not determined. Kevin pushed on with Roxx Gang, and soon after they recorded their demo in 1987 called Love 'Em and Leave 'Em. This demo was successful and led to signing with Virgin Records. They entered the studio with producer Bo Hill, who had produced records with Alice Cooper, Ratt, Warrant, and others. This lineup consisted of Kevin Steele on vocals, Jeff Taylor Blanchard on guitar, Wade Hayes on guitar, Robbie Strychnine Strine on bass, and David James Blackshire on drums. The album, Things You've Never Done Before, came out in 1988. They had some success with this album, selling about 250,000 copies worldwide, about halfway to gold. Two videos were released, No Easy Way Out and Scratch My Back. They felt they weren't being handled correctly by Virgin and negotiated a way out. CBS was going to pick them up, but that deal eventually fell through. In 1995, Kevin Steele emerged with a new version of the band. I remember some print ads saying Kevin Steele is back and ready to kick grunge's ass. They released an album on Paris Records called The Voodoo You Love. One of the new members here was Stacy Blades, who you may remember from LA Guns, among other bands. In 1997, Paris Records re-released the demo Love 'Em and Leave 'Em. In 98, they had an album called Old, New, Borrowed, and Blue, which had some old songs, some new songs, and some blues songs. In 1998, Mojo Gurus was released, which has become a band that's actually the alter ego of Kevin Steele's Roxx Gang, a more bluesy, trippy, country, sometimes honky-tonk rock-type band. In 2000, they released their final album on Paris Records, Drinking TNT and Smoking Dynamite, actually the last original record. Their final record with Paris Records was a best-of titled Bodacious Tatas, which also included some Mojo Gurus songs. Gamers, you may know Roxx Gang from the 2006 release Saints Row, which had two songs by Roxx Gang, Ball and Chain and No Easy Way Out. Now, in 2011, Roxx Gang reemerged on F&A Records and released a three-disc box set called Box of Roxx, B-O-X-X of R-O-X-X. The first disc was a disc of demos, which were of really good quality. Second was a live show from 1989, and the third was a DVD of their videos. In 2014, they also released Last Laugh. Now, 11 of the 15 songs were between 84 and 86 and featured Eric Carroll. I personally thought that the quality of the demos was not quite as high, but Kevin wanted to release something with Eric on. So if you're a completist or if you like what you hear, check out Last Laugh. I remember back in the day someone once describing their music as fast food. Tastes great while you're listening to it, but 30 minutes later, you don't remember it. I don't know if that's true, because 30 years later, I'm still playing it. I do give Roxx Gang some credit for sounding a little different than most of their contemporaries, mostly due to Kevin Steele's vocal delivery. So, I'm going to let you check some of that out right now with some samples, and then we'll wrap things up at the end.
Yeah.
So that's a little bit about Kevin Steele and Roxx Gang. Where can you check them out? You can check them out on the streaming services. Most of the stuff is on there. The videos I talked about, you can check out on YouTube. If you like what you hear on the streaming services, I always encourage people to go and buy those records. You can find them on Paris Records, P-E-R-R-I-S, or FNA Records is another one, depending on which albums you're looking for. If you want to follow me on social media, I'm going to show you how in the credits in just a second. Subscribe if you like it, and thanks again for watching.